baseball is essentially a modified game of softball for the visually impaired. Developed in the late 70s, it is pretty much played like standard. I mean, if you watched it in standard softball, you would be able to figure out what's going on. But we use a modified softball that has an electronic rechargeable beeper in it, and our bases make noise so the runners know where the bases are. Now, we've modified some rules, like the pitcher is with the hitting team as opposed to against the hitting team, because it'd be really easy to strike a blind guy out. I mean, he'd never have a chance, even with the ball beeping. So we get our guys to throw it, and the point of the pitcher is to make him hit it as best he can. The defenses, you got six guys out on the field, and they kind of divide the field up into zones. And when the ball's hit, a zone number is called, and then it's basically up to the guys to get to the ball before the runner gets to the base. If he gets to the base, it's a run. If he gets the ball before he gets to the base, it's an out. Three outs an inning, six innings a game. And like I said, if you watch regular softball and watch this, you figure out what was going on real easy.
You know, it's home field advantage. These are great fields, and we have just loved being here. And Indy Parks has treated us so good. They've tried to do everything they can to make it good for us, and they have. I think they've enjoyed it. Yeah, I think they have. You know, the game last night, I know a lot of folks enjoyed that at Victory Field. And, you know, I know everybody's just talked about how the fields have been really good, smooth. That's one thing we've always had, you know, we have issues with sometimes in certain locations. The fields are just rough and hilly, and the balls are bouncing everywhere. So, you know, these are great fields, and I think everybody's loved being in Indiana.
We've had a great time. We went out last night to the Outback Steakhouse, had some good food, you know, just enjoyed the town a little bit. And now that we're out, we'll probably do a little driving around, see what's around. Partly when you're playing, you're kind of tied here the whole day, so you really see the fields and the hotels. But as the week goes on and you kind of get eliminated, you have a little bit more time to look around. But it seems like a great place. I've been here before. Just not for a national tournament.
We run the doggy daycare. We've done that every year for Beat Baseball. And we have all of the players bring their guide dogs here. So they drop them off in the morning and we take care of them. We play with them. We give them love while the players are out there. And then they pick them up at the end of the day. I think it's just really important for the players to be able to come and play and not have to worry about their dogs and really focus on the game. Well, the dogs, of course, love Indianapolis. They think that this park especially is just perfect. They love the pond, and they're having a great time here.
You know, for me, I just love the competition. I love being out here with my friends. And, you know, when I lost my vision, I stopped being able to play basketball or flag football and all those other sports that I really enjoyed. And then I discovered Beat Baseball, and before you knew it, I was hooked.
It's a sense of normalcy. You know, I think the thing that surprises people when they first see the game is just the level of competition. It's at. It's probably, I played some 12-inch softball and stuff like that, and it's easily the most competitive thing I've ever done. So I think it's just a sense of normalcy in your life, you know?
I mean, we've got sighted people who started out 30 years ago and are still showing up. Now they're umping, but back then they were pitching. The guy who was umping this field here was a pitcher of mine back in the day in Chicago. John Lukowski used to pitch for Chicago, you know, and they keep, even after their teams are gone, they keep coming back year after year. There's something about this that draws people back. For us, it teaches us a lot about team cooperation, team sports, working together toward a goal. But another thing that's very important and sometimes gets lost are the sighted people who are part of our teams. What we've done for them is they've learned an awful lot about visually impaired people and about handicaps in general, and that just because you don't see or just because you don't walk so well or whatever doesn't mean that you can't be involved in something that can be competitive, or if you're not a competitive team, in something that's recreational and fun for everybody and that everybody can take part in. It teaches a lot of us how to work together, but also how the sighted world to kind of get used to working with us and treating us kind of more on an equal basis too.